Welcome to the Car Meet. This is the Motorfest social hub, and it's also a place where you can access all the features of the festival. Check out the main stage, where you can join in on the custom show or explore and compete to become a genuine Motorfest legend. Of course, you can hop into the playlists. You already know how wild those can get. Don't forget the live event's monthly theme. We like to change things up around here. Anyway, I'll leave you to it. Look around and have fun. Bye.
Welcome to the Custom Show. Here you can vote for your favorite vehicles of the week, or register your customized ride to the competition to get rewards based on your ranking. This playlist. Our next stop, Kaneohe. The pack is waiting for you there and is willing to show you some more of the racing culture. In fact, some of the best drivers have pushed their engines on this very road. Even notorious racing groups like the Midnight Club cut their teeth here. And that's what slightly inspired our next event.
street is that you shine like a real hasharia with my NSX. Got me interested.
Well, then I believe you're in for a treat.
Oh, yeah? Well, bring it on.
The show continues, kid. But watch out. You're driving Ren's Skyline this time, and there's no word to tell you how crazy she is about that car. Can't blame her. The R34 is a legend.
It's a kaiju.
The Skyline is an icon. It's a powerful car that takes skill to control.
Yep. Ren spent years taming that beast. That car got nicknamed Godzilla for a reason.
So basically, you crash Ren's car, better leave the planet.
Perfect to get a taste of the Wangan spirit, an absolute myth among Japanese street racers.
Yeah, picture the Tokyo Beisho route, with one thing in mind, never slowing down.
Wangan race, you gotta go fast, Bren.
Well, guys, I don't think it's gonna be a problem. This is the Skyline we're talking about.
Dragons are massive.
You got a wish to make?
Sharp turn, careful.
Time Shingo missed a turn during a midnight race, supposedly because he was dazzled by the moonlight.
Oh, shut up!
I remember that.
Drifting technique was perfected by Japanese gearheads who raced in the mountains in order to keep city pedestrians safe. Along with suboptimal road conditions, these mountain passes are filled with hairpin turns and other challenges. Drifting is the best way to take sharp turns without losing speed. In Japan, we call these passes toge. There's even a toge style of racing. The winding mountain roads of Hawaii are as close as we could get to Japan. So we figured it would be a good place to teach you.
The whole Festival Euphoria on hold for a while and get a proper face off. Let me show you what Toge is all about.
Go for it, driver. This car was made to be first only.
Relax. I've seen what you can do. Daijoubu da. Plus, I'll give you some tips on the way. Balance the brake and gas pedal at every turn. One wrong move and you're out. This technique isn't easy, but when you pull it off, you feel like the greatest driver alive and the coolest. Gen 2002 Mazda RX-7. Lightweight, compact, a sick rotary engine, and one hell of a look. That's Tanana's car, and she seems pretty confident you can beat me with it. Let's prove her wrong. It's tricky at high speed. Make sure you don't lose control. The best and also the toughest part, so stay sharp. And this is it. Come on, show me some real Toge driving. sounds like.
Is right on the coast, and the view of the ocean is stunning. At least that's what my databases tell me. Again, I'm just a robot. I hope you've liked the RX-7, because you'll be driving it again during this challenge. Except this time, she'll be waiting for you all modded and upgraded. You've seen traditional Japan. Now it's time to enter the modern age. Be prepared, the contrast is stunning.
I know. Kudos. And now, welcome to my playground, the Drift Track. As you already know, drifting was born in Japan. Like, the Ebisu Circuit is one of the most famous places in the world for drifting. Designed by drifters, for drifters. Who knows? Maybe Motorfest will get you drifting there someday. How do you feel about my modded RX-7? Tougher yet still elegant? That is my RX-7 2.0 for you. Because Japanese car culture isn't only famous for its drifting history, it also brought modded cars to another level, among many other things. Come on, you're almost done. Push that beauty to its limit. You have my permission.
gets its fair share of gearheads. There's a drag spot set up not too far from here. must complete this playlist. In a few minutes, you'll enter the world of muscle cars. Beware, you may never want to leave. Muscle cars are more than just a 70-year-old car trend. It's an entire chunk of the American car culture. To tons of people, muscle cars are the epitome of what a vehicle should represent. Allure and power, with some crucial tweaks, and just the right amount of outside-of-the-box thinking. Cars in their fullest might and glory. Want to experience it for yourself? Well, good news, we're almost there. The next objective. Don't expect the first event to be a warm-up. Things will get tough real fast. But you'll be backed up by one of the festival's closest partners, Jim Hayfield, a rock star among car collectors. The greatest muscle car collections in the world. He's the person lending us all the cars you'll drive during this playlist, and he's got quite the lineup. tracks right there. A heartbeat, the song of a V8, music on. Turn up the volume if you dare.
Head, or you're just here for the Discovery Tour, it doesn't matter. If you're into cars, you're gonna love this. Just listen to that V8, like a chunky, down-tuned guitar riff. Another lap to go. You got the path memorized? Then punch it! Jackson, Wyoming. I played there a couple of times. You know, feel good, small town kind of vibe, mountain ranges. I know, we're in Hawaii, but the mind wanders. Gotta say, I like the climate here better. That's it. Fire it up. What this playlist is all about.
Intertwined. Muscle cars became popular during the 60s. At the time, they were mostly rear-wheel drive cars made from affordable everyday vehicle bases, but equipped with powerful V8 engines from much larger machines. One of the goals in making such performance-focused cars was covering going a quarter mile as fast as possible. Can you guess which motor racing sport is about going all out for that very distance? Indeed, drag racing. There's a strip real close. A proper try is better than a thousand words.
Drag racing time. Don't overthink. Just burn and fly.
A call for freedom. The freedom to turn an ordinary car into a vehicular marvel, with a state of mind far away from luxury brand strategies and pricing, and the freedom you feel from actually being behind the wheel of said cars. But Jim should be much better than I am at conveying emotions. He's human after all.
time as one of those outrun types. Drive fast, hit the checkpoints on time. It's just like that rad game from the 80s. You digging the soundtrack? It's the spot, right? My mixtape we're listening to meshes well with the sound of the engines, you feel me? I couldn't put you through a muscle car ride without some proper riffs, could I? Are you getting from that Mustang GT? The thing about muscle cars is it's all about that optimal weight-power ratio, which brings top-notch performance, that sweet spot. At this point, you're in for a series of turns. Make sure to stay on the road. Told ya, and there's more coming. But hey, curves are part of the fun. Out of the woods. Finish big. A perfect drive. How about that?
To the next freedom-infused event, we're going to make an extra stop. We have a little surprise for you. Although in this case, little may be a poor choice of words. Just head towards the beach and you'll understand. We're real close.
Thank you.
Busta Beats. I've got the perfect hip-hop jewel for this crown. GT. Lucky for you, this is a two-lap race. You got one lap to find your footing and one to feed your opponent some dirt. Cool, show me some more. Trucks popped up in the late 70s, mostly just for showboating. They only really became a thing in the 80s. Man, that decade truly was something. You made it through the first lap. Time to crush and destroy. American monster trucks are used in two types of competitions, freestyle stunt and racing. Given Motorfest's racing DNA, we obviously went for the latter. Don't be afraid to use these banked ramps. Ready for takeoff? Yeah!
We're heading north for a race through the swamp this time. Don't worry, you'll still be driving a muscle car. The Mustang GT from 2011 is waiting for you as we speak. Except this unit is custom-made for off-roading. Jim's passion for muscle cars is not restricted to asphalt. That man would drive muscle cars on the moon if he could. spot the wind turbines, it'll mean you have arrived. Your opponents are already there. Go on and join the melee.
Prepping it like 10 minutes before you showed up. It is ready to gobble up every square mile of swampland if you ask it to. Second lap, keep up with the beat. Stay on top. It's a three-lap brawl this time. Don't waver. You can go full speed through the mud, through water, through the weeds. Same goes for these ramps, flat out. All right. Water pond. Don't think twice. That's it. Take what's yours. Mustang jump like the devil is after it. Third and last turn of that swamp cruise. Go for it and don't be afraid to get your wheels dirty. Hold on to your saddle, cowboy. Knock some teeth out. Straight line. Use that nitro.
time to rest on your laurels. Keep going, driver. We're keeping pace. The next event is just a few minutes away. A frantic race that goes from the coast to the countryside with an unmistakable Californian vibe. Your next car is one of the most recent entries when it comes to muscle cars. The 2020 Mustang Shelby GT500. Your opponents do not stand a chance. Speak to you soon, driver.